another episode of Vintage Hollywood. I'm your host, Erik Estrada. No, not the guy from Chips. There's more than one Erik Estrada in this town. So we have a very special episode tonight. We pay special tribute to some of the most iconic actors that helped pave the way for modern Hollywood. Thanks for modern science and technology, we were able to bring back two of Hollywood's most memorable personalities. First, you may know her as a kooky redhead with blue eyes that always got into wacky adventures and stole our hearts. But first, let's look at the career of the lovable redhead in this special video package.
It's so tasty, too. It tastes like candy. So why don't you join the thousands of happy peppy people and get yourself a big bottle of Vitamita Vegemin tomorrow. That's Vitamita Vegemin.
Okay, that was good, but can we try it again from where you start drinking it and you say, it's so tasty too.
Okay. It's so tasty too. That's Vitamita Vegemin. So why don't you throw in the thousands of happy peppy people and get yourself a big bottle of Vitamita Vegemin tomorrow. That's Vitamita Vegemin. Hello friends, I'm your Vitamita Vegemin girl. Are you tired, run down, listless? Do you pop out at parties? Are you unpopular? The answer to all your problems is in this little bottle right here. That's Vitamita Vegemin. That's right. It contains vitamins, minerals, and vegetables. With Vitamita Vegemin, you can spoon your way to health. All you have to do is take a big tablespoon after every meal. It's so tasty, too. So why don't you join the thousands of happy peppy people and get yourself a big bottle of Vitamita Vegemin tomorrow. That's Vitamita.
Oh, Lucy, please welcome the great Lucia Ball!
Hi, everyone! Oh, it's great to be back! Thank you! Thank you!
Wow, the great Lucia Ball sitting next to me. Isn't this something? So how are you, Lucy?
Well, I'm great, Erik, thank you. But, you know, it's awful hot in here. No, I'm kidding. I'm peachy.
Great. So, I mean, you've been back in the 21st century for how long?
Well, I've been back for a few days already. But, you know, time sure flies when you've been asleep since 1962. Apparently, I haven't missed much if you have your own talk show.
Oh, yeah. I mean, everybody has talk shows now. You should see the awful ones I've seen on YouTube.
Hey, what's that? Is that like the boob tube? Ooh, I'm not supposed to say that on television.
It's okay. It's the norm now. I mean, we say words like mother and I mean, you'll get used to it. I mean, anything and everything happens on live television.
Now, when you say anything and everything, you don't also mean that you show how babies are born too, do you?
Well, more or less if you count twerking.
Hey, what's that? Is that like the jitterbug?
Well, let's move on, Lucy. So, I mean, you knew a lot of famous people back from the golden age of television cinema. What more can you tell us about that?
Well, there's not much to tell. I mean, from what I've seen and heard, the gossip that went around back then is no different than how it is today. The only difference today now is word spread faster through text chats or Snapchats or whatever it is you people use nowadays.
Okay, so if you want to tell us how it was back then, maybe you can tell us what you think of modern Hollywood today.
I'll tell you what, Erik. I'll show you what I think of Hollywood today.
Let us see.
These are huge! Even desks aren't this big. Hello, sir. Can I please get one ticket to the next Marilyn Monroe picture, please?
Marilyn Monroe?
Yes,
we're showing Logan.
Logan? What is Logan?
It's a beautiful movie.
Beautiful movie? But I want to see Marilyn Monroe.
Oh, Marilyn Monroe? That's long ago.
Long ago?
Ugh. All right, thank you for your help.
You're welcome. Bye, Lucy.
So what else did you do in Hollywood, Lucy?
Well, you know, I was walking around and I saw a lot of kids nowadays have markings all over their bodies. So you know what? I thought I'd get a tattoo too.
Oh, tattoo! Wow, so you definitely seem to be adapting well to modern times.
Well, I don't know about that. I was walking down the street and somebody asked me to dab. I didn't know whether to shake their hand, dance, or join them for a smoke.
So what'd you end up doing?
Well, I did a little of all three just to be safe, you know?
Well, any more stories you want to tell us about your, you know, adventures in modern age?
Yeah, I was surprised to see that the world nowadays has television in color.
That's right. The world can see your bright red hair now.
Well, I just hope that the people at home are watching on a better TV than the one I have.
Why do you say that?
Well, because last night I was watching TV and the President of the United States was on. But his face looked like a burnt orange.
I promise you, Lucy, your TV was working perfectly fine.
Oh, maybe a little too fine then, if you ask me.
So, Lucy, do you think you could tell us about any of your celebrity friends?
Well, I have very fond memories of one of the smartest and funniest female comedians ever, Joan Rivers. May she rest in peace. Joan had a way of getting a room of people laughing so hard you'd have thought that someone filled the place with laughing gas.
You and Joan were breaking down doors in the comedy world. In fact, didn't she just guest star on your show, Here's Lucy?
Yes, she did. And I'll tell you what, she was such an amazing person to have on set. I thought they were going to kick me out and rename the show Here's Joan.
All right, well, I'm glad you brought back up Joan, just because before she passed, she only had the nicest things to say about you. She was quoted in saying that you were tough, smart, and brilliant comedian and walking masterclass in comedy.
Oh, well, every one of those compliments can be said right back about Joan, too. We knew that we had to be tough, you know? The world was made for men back then, and Joan and I knew that the only thing women were expected to say was, "Dinner's ready." And so to make it clear, we made it clear that we weren't going to play by those rules.
I mean, you had such a long career. Surely you have stories that was something that went on with the Louis B. Brothers in the mayor's office or something zany that happened with the Marx Brothers.
Well, sorry to disappoint, darling, but there are some things that a person will never say. I will tell you this, though. Some of the best times of my life were with Desi. You know, my husband and I Live Lucy and husband in real life. And that is all I have to say about that.
Well, some things are better said on set, huh? Mm-hmm. That was great. We knew the great chemistry you had with Desi Arnaz and all the other cast members. We just want to thank you. Thank you. Thank you for your time. And we're just so glad that you're here. Thank you for being here, Lucy.
Oh, well, thank you. It's so great to be here, Erik. Let's have a cigarette sometime, huh, Professor Philip Morris?
We'll have to talk more about that later. We come to our first commercial break. Stay tuned for another special guest when we return.
Question: when was the last time you tasted a cookie this good?
Answer: never.
What other cookie do you know is so sweet it can make a ginger snap?
Only Sweet Treats cookies.
What other cookie do you know is so delicious that it can make a diamond ring?
Only Sweet Treats cookies.
We could spend all day discussing all the things that the mouth-watering flavor of Sweet Treats cookies can do, but every passing second is a cookie you could have eaten.
Whoops, there goes a cookie. Uh-oh, there goes two cookies. Boy, you are just throwing those cookies away.
So how about you pick up your wallet, pick up your keys, get in your car, and drive down to Sweet Treats.
Try our new mint chocolate chip. So hot, it makes steam look cool, with a rush of icy mint sure to make the coolest polar bear shiver.
Or give our world-famous oatmeal cookies a try. So sweet and succulent that it will have you saying, I can't believe it's not a dream. Sweet Treats, our treats are so sweet, they put the eat back in it. Sweet Treats.
Oh, yeah.
Welcome back to our special episode of Vintage Hollywood. We just had Lucille Ball a little while ago, and now we're ready for our next guest. He was a little quiet back in the day, but it's not because he was shy. He was from the silent era. His movies did all of his talking. You may remember him as a quirky character known as a tramp. To the man that needs no intro, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the one, the only, Charlie Chaplin! Oh, Charlie, it is an honor to meet you. All right. Still not much of a talker, huh? Well, maybe you can act out your answers for us. So, how do you like the 21st century? Ah, we are living in crazy times right now. Sorry you had to come and witness that. But is there anything specifically that you do like about the 21st century? What is it? Ah, you like the iPhone. Well, sure. I mean, everyone likes the iPhone or smartphone. I mean, it's the best way to communicate. I mean, what specifically do you like about the iPhone? Pictures. You like to take pictures. Charlie, you gotta have some self-control, buddy.
It's hard to have self-control when you come from a time where it took 5 minutes to take a single picture.
He speaks! Ladies and gentlemen, Charlie Chaplin speaks!
Oh, it was hard not to break character. You know, the way they make television shows, it's so different now.
Yeah, I mean, I know you were mainly into doing films in your time. Did you ever get a television show or a television deal of some sort?
Oh, no. Look, I never wanted to do television. I'll be honest, when television first came out, I thought it was going to be short-lived. I thought it was just a fad due to the popularity of films.
Ah, so you're saying that I'm a schmuck for having my television show, huh?
No, of course not, old boy. Television has its mark in the world already. I mean, truth be told, people thought I was crazy doing pictures back then. The safest thing for me to do was vaudeville, which is where most early cinema and television actors began. In fact, let me show you some of my favorite places where I was on top.
Let us see.
Thank you.
Wow, that was great. I mean, thanks for sharing all your locations with us. So much has changed since the early 21st century, huh?
Yes, well, you know what they say, the more things change, the more they stay the same and all that.
Too true. So, Charlie, I mean, this is not the first time you've spoken on, you know, on film before, or television, I suppose. You once had a great performance in the film The Great Dictator, which, you know, you produced, you directed, you starred in. What can you tell us about that?
I was a busy bee at that time.
Yeah, I mean, you're sure you were. I mean, do you think you could tell us, like, what it was working on a film that satirized Nazism when it was the most prominent?
Look, it was a thrill, if I'm being completely honest. Imagine, if you will, living in a world where an angry little man is building an army that will spread hate and destruction, you know, wherever it goes. How can you not poke fun at that?
So you had plenty of material to work with.
Too much, quite frankly. I wrote that film when Nazism was at its strongest, when Hitler was treating the world like his rubbish and his soldiers like cattle. It was a time where smiles were very rare. And as a comedian, I felt it was my duty to fix that.
I mean, but that film didn't just bring smiles to people's faces. It also spread a message of unity, didn't it?
I certainly hope it did. I wanted to remind the audience that it didn't matter what you ate for breakfast, how you spell color, or what part of the globe you live in. What matters is that we're all humans, not soulless machines, and only together can humanity advance to greatness.
Definitely.
We must remember that we cannot move forward by butting heads, but only by supporting each other.
Definitely. I mean, it's definitely a timeless message. I mean, it's a good thing that you're back, because some would say we're living in a time like that right now. I mean, feel like the world has forgotten that message.
Yes. Look, I've seen that the world has been set ablaze by recent political events.
What do you say? You have any words of advice for these crazy times for us?
Yes. I want to wish the comedians of this era good luck. You know, as they will be faced with not just keeping the human spirit strong through comedy, but also tasked with using satire to criticize any atrocities that may be committed.
I mean, there definitely has been satire made by comedians about our current, political landscape, but I don't think they're taking seriously. I mean, do you have any advice on how they can push their message?
Persistence. Persistence is the name of the game. I mean, you know, even if we only make one person laugh a day, give us a year, and that's 365 smiles.
Wow, that's amazing, Charlie. Well, that's the time we have for today. We're going to go on to our next commercial break. Don't go anywhere. Stay tuned.
In a world of competitive cupcake baking, only the strong survive. This January, join the Henrietta sisters as they fight to become champions of the World Cupcake Bake-Off in a land where the competition is fierce and the frosting is delicious. These twins must fight against all odds to win the championship and get the prize money in order to save their dying mother, dying of diabetes. Join us this coming January for Cupcake Apocalypse. Who will survive? Only the strong will know. They will face the snootiest panel of judges in all of the world, from Germany to Lithuania, to South Africa, and Estonia. They know what it takes to make the greatest cupcake in the world. Will you be there to witness it? Comes out January 1st.
Thanks for joining us again, ladies and gentlemen. I'm your host, Erik. If you're just joining us, we had special guests brought back from the past. Let's welcome back Lucille Ball.
Oh, great. It's great to be back again. Oh, hello. Oh,
Hello.
Oh, thank you.
Wow, seeing two of Hollywood legends sitting next to each other across from me is mind-boggling. I mean, I've seen all your films and you know, TV shows since I was a kid.
Oh, please, we're too humble to be called legends. We're just us.
Let's just say that we're legends in the studio, not Hollywood.
All right. Well, now since we have both of you here today, I wanted to bring back vaudeville for one night only, starring Lucille Ball and Charlie Chaplin. So for this performance, we're going to see a bizarre episode of I Love Lucy, where Charlie plays your husband, Ricky Ricardo. Let us see.
Oh, good morning, Ricky. Mwah. I was just about to make some breakfast. What do you feel like having? Well, what's wrong, Ricky? Why aren't you talking? Did you bite your tongue while chewing gum again? Are you tired? Are you sick? You're hungry? Well, food will get you talking. You better give a speech after every bite. Can you at least tell me what you're hungry for? What's that? You want pork? You want steak? You want both? Can't you just tell me what you want? I'm getting upset now.
Great. I mean, Charlie, now we know what it'd been like if you would have done television. I mean, I just want to say thank you to the both of you guys for being here. Your contributions to the industry have been, you know, major, and you guys are the pioneers, and without your influences, you know, Hollywood wouldn't be what it is today. So it's all to your hard work and dedication to the industry that, you know, we are here today. So I wanted to present both of you guys with some awards. Cool. All right. Well, first, I present the Hollywood Legends Award for the groundbreaker to Lucille Ball for paving the way for female comedians. Without your impact, we wouldn't have modern-day actress comedians like Tina Fey, Fran Drescher, Julia Louis-Dreyfus, and big thanks for helping Hispanics into the Hollywood, as well as having your real-life husband, Desi Arnaz, play your husband, who was from Cuba on I Love Lucy. Thank you.
This really means a lot to me. Thank you. I really hope more young women are watching this to get inspired to put themselves out there. You know, just if you can imagine it, you can achieve it.
Yes, and I'm sure they will. Thanks to you, Lucy. Oh. All right, next, I want to present the Hollywood Legends Award for the comedic icon to Charlie Chaplin for helping elevate the movie industry to heights never thought imaginable. Thanks to your iconic character in The Tramp and for making the film into a true art form, Charlie. Thank you.
Thank you, old chap.
Let's give them one big round of applause. Woo! All right, guys. That's all the time we have, folks. Let's give our Hollywood legends one more last round of applause. And thanks for joining us, ladies and gentlemen. Join us next time for the next episode of Vintage Hollywood. I'm your host, Erik. Good night, everyone.